Republican presidential debates shattered ratings records with his combative celebrity at the wheel at the center of this program. Now seen in hosting tonight's first Democratic candidate class in the 2016 presidential race, featuring Hillary Clinton, Bernie Sanders, Martin O'Malley, Jim Webb, and Lincoln Chafee. Vice President Joe Biden, by the way, expected to skip this debate. U.S. Senator Brian Schatz looking ahead with us this morning here on Wake Up Today. Good morning, Senator.
Nice to see you.
Welcome home. Okay, how can viewers what can viewers expect tonight? I'm curious to see how this one will unfold.
Well, I think you're not going to see quite the level of fireworks that you would see with Donald Trump. He's a reality star. You can't compete with that. And I think, you know, it's an odd-numbered year, so people are watching TV, and there's no one that is better TV than Donald Trump. But I think when it comes to governing, people are going to get serious, and this debate is going to be more on the issues. I think it will be highly rated because there's a good appetite for people to see what Bernie Sanders is all about. And then to sort of rekindle their enthusiasm for Hillary Clinton. I'm a big, strong supporter of Hillary Clinton. I think she's far and away the most qualified candidate for president, but we haven't seen very much of her. The people who see her are the people in the early voting states, New Hampshire and Iowa. The rest of us across the country want to see, hear, and think about her in terms other than Trey Gowdy and the Benghazi committee and all that.
Else about her cell phone, if you will. Bernie, you talk about New Hampshire. Bernie Sanders making some waves and causing a stir. What do you think the key issues will be coming up?
Well, I think you know, Bernie's doing really well in New Hampshire because it's adjacent to his home state, and also New Hampshire has an independent voting streak. And Bernie is a good friend of mine, but I think it's not really a close call when it comes to being qualified for the presidency. These are dangerous times. These are difficult times. And what we see with the House Republicans is that it actually matters to have experience with governing. And there's nobody, as a former Secretary of State, a former First Lady, someone who's advocated for women and children all of her life, there's just nobody that has ever been so well prepared for the presidency. And I think when it comes down to the voting, people are going to kind of settle down, turn off their reality television programming, and get serious. And I think Hillary will be both the nominee and the next president.
Personal jabs, I think, will be minimal, if you will.
I think so. I think they like each other. You know, Bernie and Hillary served together in the caucus. Hillary came about 6 weeks ago to visit the Democratic conference in the Senate. It was very cordial. There is a collegiality among current and former senators, which I think is going to carry the day. That may mean that it's not going to have 30 million or 40 million people watching, but it's going to be a more substantive debate focused on what people actually need to have fixed.
I got to throw this at you just because it is the story of the morning right now. And one person who would be watching from home, if you will be Congressman Gabbard. Your thoughts on what the fallout of that?
Well, I think we ought to have more debates, and the reason that I think we ought to have more debates is that I really support Senator Clinton and Secretary Clinton, and the challenges I think we've had is that we haven't gotten our point across. We haven't had an opportunity for the Democrats to articulate what their policy prescriptions for the country would be, and so we can't just sit here lying in wait and let the Republicans sort of beat us up. So I think we ought to have more debates. I don't know the nature of the dispute between Debbie Wasserman Schultz and Tulsi, but if the idea is that there should be more democracy, more conversation, I agree with that.
All right. It all starts, of course, CNN 2:30 Hawaii time, live in Las Vegas. You can catch it right here on KH12. And as you can see, we have a live shot coming to you from Las Vegas. Real quickly, I got to wrap this up. The U.S. Secretary of Air Force is also here in the islands, speaking this morning in a very important forum.
Yeah, this is Secretary of the Air Force Deborah Lee James. She's the second confirmed female nominee who's head of a service branch. She came to Hawaii, and I've been able to connect her with a group called Women in Renewable Energy. And so she's going to speak this morning at 7:30 to renewable energy professional women. The Air Force has done great things. They've invested about $4 million into the joint bases at Pearl Harbor Hickam. We're hoping there will be tens of millions of dollars additionally invested in helping the Air Force to get more efficient and to move towards alternative fuels. But this is a real honor for our WIRE group, the Women in Renewable Energy, and I'm happy to have the Secretary here.
We welcome her to the islands. Welcome home.
Nice to see you.
All right, we'll be tuning in tonight, 2:30 for the presidential debate.